So you write this line. In 1991, RBI devalued the rupee. That helped in boosting agricultural exports. That helped in boosting agricultural exports. Okay. Full stop. High agricultural exports led to the increase in agri GDP. Led to the increase in agri GDP. Okay, I hope you understand. But what happened after 1995? Again, India experienced decline in the productivity of agriculture. Then there was a question that what is the main reason? So due to shrinking in the land holdings of these agriculture sector, India experienced low agriculture growth rate. Now what are the reasons behind contraction or shrinking in land holdings? Number one is urbanization. So rapid urbanization after 1991. Fragmentation, because suppose, for example, if there is one family, father and mother is having four sons, then obviously if they are working on one farm, but after marriage and later on they will divide this farm into four pieces. So this is the farm. If this will be divided into four pieces, it means lot of area will be wasted in bordering and fencing. If you are implementing modern inputs like tractor, etc., tractor will roam around this area. Uske aage tak there will be no use of this. If we want this particular one, we can say one go down, etc., on every farm. So that led to decline in the land holdings. So number one reason is rapid urbanization. Second reason is fragmentation of land holdings. So we write this.
Can you see the limitation in soil quality?
That is also, but that experience later on around 2005-2008 due to the effects of global warming as well. So you write, after 1995, India again experienced decline in agricultural growth rate. The main reason behind low productivity was shrinking of land holdings. Due to rapid urbanization and fragmentation of land holdings. Full stop. During this time, the agricultural growth rate was around 2%. So you know that potential growth rate in agriculture sector is 4%. And India achieved only 2%. Later on, new agriculture policy initiated in the year 2000, and after 2000, agriculture growth rate has started increasing. But that agriculture growth rate was crop specific. Do you understand what's the meaning of crop specific growth rate? Agriculture is growing, but only on the back of few crops, wheat, rice, etc. Not this growth rate is not distributed among
all crops. So right. At the advent of 21st century, agricultural growth rate has started increasing. But that growth was only crop specific. Full stop. From 2011, India experienced regional variation. In the agricultural growth rate. First off, the growth during 2011-2016 was around 2% on an average. So that's the end of all the timeline. I hope you understand all the timelines. Okay. Now we'll write the challenges. Challenges in front of agriculture. These challenges are very important because throughout the discussion of our agriculture sector, we'll able to find or we'll try to find the solution to these challenges. These challenges are universal for the whole country. And these challenges are very, very vital to provide food security in future. Because agriculture sector is struggling with lot of problems. Check. N number of problems. Sachin is smiling. Check. So, you write challenges. You understand regional variation of crops? Do you understand? Like for example, I'll give you one example that if government is, but you will understand this example after we'll discuss MSP. But as I mentioned, so whenever you are announcing MSP for one particular crop, like wheat and rice, more and more, everyone is interested in sowing that particular crop. Like for example, at 1 year, at the time around 2015, I guess, government increased the MSP on rice. So whenever farmers saw that the MSP on rice has been increasing, they started growing rice. And that too in areas which are geographically not suitable for rice. Example was Vidarbha region, where we do not have a lot of water. And you know, rice requires a lot of water. Flood irrigation, if you understand. Suppose this is the rice farm and these chairs are like rice crops. So you have to fill this particular farm till this height. Flood irrigation. And where we do not have a lot of water. But just because of government policy of higher and higher MSP. That is the result. What happened at the time of drought in 2015? Due to monsoon failure. No water, no irrigation. Led to crop failure and ultimately farmer suicide. That is the main problem. So government should rethink before announcing MSP. So regional variations are very, very detrimental for Indian agriculture sector. Abhi thoda sa, maybe we can say that they are getting their mind back and they are announcing MSP in quite sensible thing. Okay, so we write challenges. First one. The biggest challenge, to achieve high agricultural growth rate, achieve higher agriculture growth rate, there are two options.
Okay.
First one, increase the land area. Second, increase the productivity or yield. Increase the yield. Y-I-E-L-D. Increase the yield. So after the first point in bracket, you write near to impossible or most difficult. Okay, so we have only one option. We have only one option to increase agriculture yield. And how will you do this? High-yield variety seeds. But you have already exhausted that option. Now the quality of soil is deteriorating. What will happen? Next solution, no one knows. In order to provide food security, we need to increase yield. And we are trying to move towards organic farming. There is one line, if you mention that line, because I've written one article in newspaper, heading maine nahi di thi, but whenever I've submitted that article to the editor, he gave one beautiful heading to my article. Heading mera kuch aur tha. Like, the organic farming is not the solution of wrongdoings under Green Revolution. I hope you understand this. Organic farming is not the solution of the mistakes or wrongdoings under Green Revolution. So what was the mistakes or what was the negative repercussion of Green Revolution? Organic farming is not the solution of that. Because organic farming will save your soil. But what about productivity? Getting my point? So you write this line somewhere in the corner or wherever you want. Organic farming is not the solution of the wrongdoings of Green Revolution. So, I think we have written one point only. Second point you write, lower productivity is the second most important challenge. Lower productivity is the second most important challenge in front of policy makers. In front of policy makers. Do you know why GS paper 3 means agriculture? GS paper 3 economics is equivalent to agriculture. Why? Because UPSC generally asks questions where government do not have any solution. So they will ask the aspirants about the solution. And in agriculture sector, even big economists of India do not have solution. So that is why they frequently ask agricultural questions. This year, the questions on agriculture sector were less comparatively to the last 4 or 5 years. Because in agriculture sector, hardly any solution exists. Now, you know that till this point, we have discussed a lot of things. What do you think? It is like we are stuck in between. We do not increase the productivity. We do not increase the land area. How we will increase the rural income? How will it decrease the poverty? On the other hand, we have committed under National Food Security Act 2013 to provide subsidized food grains, etc. We, on the one hand, we are thinking about investment, but on the other, we are providing a lot of subsidies. Capital formation, if you remember the word capital formation, it means forming the capital from saving to investment. So capital formation in agriculture sector, if we compare the data, this is the exact data published by Government of India. In 1980, that capital formation was around 3.8% of GDP, capital formation. And that declined to 2.2% in 2014. From 3.8% in 1980, capital formation. Likhu kya main?
3.8%, and in 2016 declined to 2.2%. Capital formation. The decline of more than 1 percentage point, it's huge. So that is what we call capital formation, means investment. And on the other hand, if we compare subsidies, it was around 2.2% in 1980. And the growth in subsidy, you can see the difference. These are exact data published by Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. So you can see the difference in agriculture investment and agricultural subsidies.
So the investment from whose side? The farmers or the
government? Government, public, public investment.
So how loan behavior affect agriculture?
We'll discuss later. We'll discuss everything, but just to understand loan waiver, first we need to understand agricultural credit. I'll discuss loan waiver as a topic. Agriculture ka hai hai, matlab, it's, there is no chronology from investment to credit. That yesterday I told you that I'll start agriculture from backward linkages to forward linkages. Backward linkages, you understand? All the inputs to the farm, all the inputs like agriculture investment, research, then seeds, all the inputs, modern inputs. Then we'll move on to productivity. Then we'll go agriculture, marketing, getting my point? Food processing industries, exports, etc. So we'll discuss this in this particular timeline. So you will understand much better. We'll discuss loan waiver. I'll tell you what are the effects. Generally, we'll discuss loan waiver under insurance. Agriculture insurance is one of the heading. So whenever I'll discuss Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana, kal aapne the Hindu padha hoga to usme Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana pe aaya tha. So how much profit these private companies are making? Likha tha usme 21,000 crore is the estimated profit of these companies, private companies. I will not name them, but you know that news on the front page. And what happened about the insurance? Farmers are opting out of it. 15% farmers opted out of Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima. 2 saal se premium bhar rahe hain, kuch mil nahi raha crop failure ko. What they will do? Obviously they will opted out. Theek hai, I'll explain. Agar abhi karunga to fir tab nahi kar paunga, aur fir link tut jayega aur wahan ka suspense khatam ho jayega. Because it's like a story. If you understand in the form of story, you will remember. Theek hai, so this data, this particular data generally I give in agriculture investment, but yahan baat aayi to I've given this. If you want to note, you can write this data, important data. Because now government is thinking about removing subsidy and moving towards public investment. So you can see that this is a justification that we should move away from subsidies and provide public investment. Subsidies kya hai? These are consumable. That will not create any asset. If you remember the yesterday discussion of yesterday class, these are revenue expenditure, subsidies. That will not create any asset.
So,
yeah. So,
but the subsidies are given to fertilizers, irrigation
facilities, free electricity.
They will create expenses.
Not how? Free electricity, you have seen how it is used. But
policy is asset.
But free goods always detrimental for the economy. Free. There should be no concept of free. If you want to give, suppose for example, there is a festival time, if you want to give certain amount of money to that person, aapko lag raha hai ki aapke ghar pe bahut der se koi kaam kar raha hai, bahut saalon se, so you should give 5-10,000 rupees to that particular person. Wo 5-10,000 if you give, that he will consume. Diwali hai, kapde khareed diye sab. But if you buy a particular, like thela khareed ke de diya aapne usko 2-3,000 ka, he can take certain amount of, we can say, garbage, etc. He can sell something on that. That is what we call capacity building. That is the requirement of the current situation of the economy. You should not provide free. If everything is free, how many of you, matlab mujhe puchna nahi chahiye, but fir bhi, how many of you opted out from that LPG subsidy? Only one?
Mera to
हाँ ठीक है, जो भी है जो भी है, बट
अपन जैसे और भी लोग हैं, दे हैवंट ऑप्टेड आउट, दे डू नॉट रिक्वायर्ड एलपीजी सब्सिडी, बट वॉट हैपन, नहीं हम टैक्स पे कर रहे हैं, सब्सिडी मिलनी चाहिए। ये मेरा रिसर्च है ग्राउंड लेवल पे, आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट, दैट्स द माइंड सेट ऑफ द पीपल। तो गवर्नमेंट ने पहले तो बोला वॉलेंट्री, देन बोला अबव 10 लाख इफ यू हैव एनुअल इनकम देन देयर विल बी नो सब्सिडी फॉर यू। सो वी आर रैशनलाइजिंग गवर्नमेंट एक्सपेंडिचर, जो मैंने आपको कल लिखा है ना, वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ फिस्कल प्रूडेंस, दैट इज रैशनलाइजेशन ऑफ गवर्नमेंट एक्सपेंडिचर, सिंपल। सो यही है सब्सिडी, सी द ग्रोथ रेट 8% इन सब्सिडीज सेम पीरियड। थर्ड पॉइंट, द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ अंडर कल्टिवेटेड और अंडर कल्टिवेशन ऑफ लैंड, द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ अंडर कल्टिवेशन ऑफ लैंड। What do you understand by under cultivation? So here we are talking about increasing the land area, and on the other hand we are talking about under cultivation. What do you think, these are contradictory or not? On the one hand we are saying that we should increase the land area, but whenever we have land area we are not utilizing it fully. Underutilization of any resources, like suppose for example in this hall there are a lot of vacant seats, so that is the underutilization of resources. Getting my point? Agar yahan ek student aur aake baith jaye, there will be extra cost? No, main bhi utni tezi padhaunga, main bhi utna hi padhaunga, bijli ka bill bhi utna aayega, there is no extra cost, but actually this is the underutilization of the resources. So under cultivation of land area means whenever we have land but we do not have that amount of seeds, that amount of water, so that we can irrigate all the land. So this is also one of the most important problem, that under cultivation of the land area in our country. Obviously if these are not skilled laborers, because now onwards modern agriculture inputs requires skillful labor. मशीन चलानी है, ट्रैक्टर चलाना है, थ्रेशर चलाना है, आसान थोड़ी ना, कार चलाना आसान होता है। सीरियसली चलाया आपने? ट्रैक्टर भी आसान होता है, बाकी चीज़ें नहीं होती ना, 4-5 गियर होते हैं, देखा आपने? सो दीज आर नॉट इजी, यू नीड स्किल्स ऑब्वियसली, ठीक है। सो लिख लिया अंडर कट। नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, थर्ड पॉइंट इज फूड सिक्योरिटी। Food security is also the biggest challenge from the demand side. Now there are other miscellaneous challenges that we'll write in the last point. But there is one external challenge to India's agriculture sector. Can you guess? External challenge to India's agriculture sector. Aid me.
Sir, the price of the agriculture produced in other countries are very less due to the subsidies provided by the...
Okay. That's the challenge to India's agriculture from the imports. What do you think about that, India's domestic agriculture production is getting challenge from the outside world, any organization, country, etc. If we think about India's agriculture sector, which organization comes into your mind? WTO. So you write next point, challenges posed by World Trade Organization. We'll discuss extensively WTO in one class, so 2.5 hours I'll devote to World Trade Organization just after the agriculture sector. So maybe this is your 16th, 17th, 18th. Today is Thursday. So this is your 19th class. So maybe in 23rd or maybe 24th class, we will discuss WTO. Because tab tak to agriculture hi chalega. So you can understand the importance of this topic. It will take around 10 to 15 hours. Okay. So So challenges posed by WTO, because WTO puts certain kind of limits on the production, certain kind of limits on the subsidies. Like you cannot give 10% or more subsidies. So beyond 10%, it is not allowed. And that 10% on the basis of base year taken by WTO of 1986. So now you can see that we must have discussed about base year. There are two conditions under base year. It should be the latest year and it should be a normal year. So what do you think about the base year of providing subsidies is 1986 under WTO. Other like TFA and other things we'll discuss in WTO are creating problem for high agriculture production. The last point you write, some miscellaneous points, like lower investment in agriculture, lower agricultural credit, comma, challenges in marketing, failure of land reforms, and disparities among rich and poor farmers. ठीक है.
What is coming in the pandemic times, in the climate change?
That climate change will come under agriculture growth and agriculture productivity. Because whenever we elaborate agriculture productivity, climate change is the most important factor. लिख सकते हो, लिख. Climate change, you write next point. कोई point गलत सही नहीं है. हाँ.
So what about the challenges posed by the seed companies?
Seed companies like agriculture investment is your seeds, investing in seeds, inputs. So these are come under this. These are macro challenges, and I'm sure that these challenges will not be undertaken in the next 50 years. Agar 50 saal baad bhi main class le raha hunga na, these challenges will remain same for Indian agriculture sector. Badal denge pakka. पढ़ा रहा हूँ ना इतने ध्यान से. बिकॉज यू नो दैट अपार्ट फ्रॉम इकोनॉमिक्स, इफ यू थिंक अबाउट, बिकॉज आई लाइक हिस्ट्री एज वेल मोर देन इकोनॉमिक्स, आई लाइक इंटरनेशनल रिलेशन एटसेट्रा. बट हियर द कंडीशन, इफ यू एनालाइज द सोसाइटी, इफ यू सी द पास्ट, पास्ट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, इट शोज मिरर टू द सोसाइटी. लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन इंडिविजुअल्स लाइफ, लाइक पीपल हु गिव यू सर्टेन काइंड ऑफ क्रिटिकल एनालिसिस, these people are very good for your personality. So never eliminate these people. Like for example, if we compare the two government, the current government and the famous government of Indira Gandhi, because of the majority they are enjoying. At the time of Indira Gandhi, she never eliminated left. Left ko kabhi eliminate nahi kiya. Why? Because left always shows you mirror that you are going in the wrong direction. Now what is happening in the current situation? Demolishing the statue of Lenin in Tripura after election. Kya ho gaya usse? Nothing. So these are the signals. Think about farming activity. Tamil Nadu farmers are protesting here in Jantar Mantar. Kuch hua? 2 saal se. 2 years. 2016. Kaise protest kar rahi, you know? They are drinking their own urine. They are eating rats. They don't have water, they are saying. Other things, they are putting skulls, human skulls. Farmer suicide jinka hua na, unka skull leke aaya hu. They are real skulls. Silent protest since last 2 years. Government nahi sun rahi. Inko kya chahiye? Wo MP mein hua tha June 2017 mein. Firing, bus ko aag laga diya, lit up other villages. क्योंकि वो लकी एस्केप था मेरे लिए. उस दिन मुझे लग रहा था कि शायद आज मैं भी विक्टिम बन जाऊंगा. आई वॉज ट्रैवलिंग, तो मेरा एसी वॉल्वो में रिजर्वेशन था, मैंने स्लीपर में कराया है नॉन एसी, ताकि मैं विंडो से कूद सकूं. मैं अपनी आंखों से देखा. तो फार्मर्स आर प्रोटेस्टिंग एंड दीज आर द सिग्नल्स. इफ यू विल नॉट लर्न, आपने वीडियोज देखा होगा कि पूरा ट्रक का टैंकर खाली कर दिया मिल्क का, अनियंस आर थ्रोइंग ऑन द रोड्स एटसेट्रा. दीज आर प्रोटेस्ट, दीज आर सिग्नल्स. इफ गवर्नमेंट इज नॉट टेकिंग सीरियसली दीज सिग्नल्स, ऑब्वियसली दिस विल बी अ ह्यूज बर्स्ट, दैट वॉट वी बबल बन जाएगा, एंड दैट बबल विल बी बर्स्ट इन द नियर फ्यूचर. इसलिए घर पे ना थोड़ा राशन रखना एक्स्ट्रा, क्योंकि दैट इज़ माई प्रिडिक्शन दैट इन द नेक्स्ट 2-3 ईयर्स कुछ भी हो सकता है, एक दिन आपको कुछ मिलेगा ही नहीं. एंड वेन देयर इज हैवॉक, यू नो दैट इफ यू नो अ फ्रेंच रेवोल्यूशन दैट वॉज ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ फूड ब्रेड. जितने रेवोल्यूशन थे वो जब मतलब खतरनाक स्प्रिंग टाइप फॉर रिफॉर्म आया, दैट इज जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ फूड. यू कैन नॉट इंटरफेयर विद द फूड ऑफ द पीपल. 2013, what happened to onion prices? You know the result of 2014 general election. People will not tolerate if you will interfere with the food. Khana dete raho, petrol price kitne hi bada do, koi farak nahi padta. But it's all about do not interfere. And government is doing this. They are not taking seriously. Even Vivek Debaroy do not have any answer. Seriously. Because on record, he was not ready to talk about agriculture, but off the record, he was literally sharing that agriculture has a lot of problem. Okay.